When I am updating HSK2 content, some students and subscribers asked me why there wasn't any HSK1 content. Well, now the HSK1 content is here. But unlike HSK2, I wouldn't be going through each dialogue line by line, because apart from HSK2, most of the other conversations in the books are not really used in real life. Instead, I will be focusing on explaining the vocabulary in detail. When we move on to HSK3, I will also be focusing on only vocabularies. I will be posting HSK1 vocabulary videos for 6 days straight. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, don't forget to subscribe it and hit the bell. Then you wouldn't miss out any updates. At the end of the book, there is a list of 145 new vocabulary words arranged alphabetically. I will be categorizing them by part of a speech and explaining a few different words under 3 parts of a speech each time. This way, you will be able to start forming sentences quickly. All right, let's get started. Let's start by the pronouns. The single form, 你, 他, 他, 我. She and he in Chinese, you can notice they're totally pronounced same, even the characters look quite similar. So during our speaking, even for 2 Chinese people, if without any context, we can't tell people are mentioned she or he. Plural form of people, 们, 我们, 你们, 他们. Let's see the verb, 是. 是 in Chinese contains is, am, are, was, were. 不是, negative form. And some nouns related to job and relationships. 老师, 医生, 朋友, 同学, 学生. The plural form of them, 学生们, 同学们, 朋友们, 医生们, 老师们. 学, this character 学 means learn, it's a verb. 同学, 同 has the meaning of do something together, so study together, classmate. 学生, 生 has the meaning of young people, so young people who are learning, they are students, 学生. As young people, so do here, 医生. 医 means medical related. So young people who are doing medical related stuff, they are doctors, 医生. 老师, when vocabulary end by 师, generally related to some professional positions. During HSK 2 or 3, the vocabulary like designer, engineer, lawyer, auditor, translate to Chinese, they all end by 师, 老师, teacher. Now we can make a sentence. 他是老师, he is teacher. 他不是医生, he is not doctor. 我们是同学, we are classmate. As a pronoun, 这, 那, 这是狗, 那是猫. More verbs, 有, negative form, 没有, 我没有猫, 他没有狗. Another groups of verbs and nouns, 在, 不在, 商店, 饭店, 店 as a character means shop or stall. 商店, 商 has meaning of commercial, 饭 has meaning of meal. So the meal shop, restaurant, commercial shop, stall, shop. 家, 学校, 学 we've already mentioned means learn something. 校 means the place for you to learn something. So 学校 together means school. 医院, 医 means medical related. Yuan is a big building with a roof. You will notice some of the place-related vocabularies that contains Yuan. Some countries' name this not contains in the HSK1 vocabulary list, so I only list 5 countries for you to practice. 中国, 英国, 法国, 美国, 国 means country. Now we can use 在 to link them as a sentence. 他在家, 我在学校, 我们在中国. Okay, so far we've already learned 3 verbs and their negative forms. 是, 有, 在. Now let's learn a particle. 的, 的, neuter tone. In Chinese, 的 contains a lot of meanings. In today's case, 的 has a function of to showing the positionship. 我的, 他的, 我们的, yours, his, her, ours. 我的老师, my teacher. 他的学生, 我们的猫. More relationships vocabularies. 爸爸, 妈妈, 女儿, 儿子. 他的女儿, 你的爸爸. Let's link this particle with the verbs. 这是我的狗. 那是我的老师. 她是我的妈妈. 我的爸爸在那. 我的老师在这. Okay, so far you've learned some basic declarative sentences. Before we learn question sentences, let's have a quick review. We learned 16 nouns from the vocabulary list, an extra 4 country names, 3 most important verbs, 是, 有, 在, and 7 pronouns, 你, 他, 我, and the plural form, 我们, 这, 那, and one of the particle, 的. Okay, let's see some question particles. 吗? 吗 question can be answered by yes or no. So, 吗 in Chinese kind of similar as are or do in English. 哪儿? Where? This one to ask people's location. 哪儿? 那? 那 also ask location. I will mention the difference later. 谁? You also can pronounce as 谁? Two pronunciations, same meaning. 谁? 谁? You can use both of them. Means who? 什么? What? Okay, let's see the examples. 他是谁? He is who? The question word be put at the end of the sentence. Who is he? In Chinese, the order is he is who? 他是谁? 这是什么? This is what? What is this? 这是什么? 什么 also be put at the end. 你是老师吗? You are teacher. And question word can be answered by yes or no. 是 or 不是. 你在哪儿? You at where? Where are you? 你在哪儿? 哪儿 at the end. 妈妈呢? Mama question word directly. Compare with 你在哪儿 or 妈妈在哪儿. 妈妈呢 has the meaning of I thought mom should be here, but isn't. Then where is mom? When you use 哪儿 to ask people's location, you really don't know where is it, where is the thing. But when you use ne to ask people's location, you thought it should be at somewhere. Ne also can be used in other situations. 我是老师，你呢？ How about you? 我在家，你呢？ I at home. How about you? 你在学校吗？你有猫吗？ So my question generally we are together with one of the verb, and the answer we are based on these verbs. 你是老师吗？ The answer should be 是 or 不是。你在学校吗？ The verb is 在, so the answer should be 在 or 不在。你有猫吗？ The verb is 有, so the answer should be 有 or 没有。Let's check out some dialogues.
他是谁？
他是我的老师。
这是谁的猫？
是我朋友的。
谁的猫？
Whose cat?
他是你的老师吗？
不是，他是我爸爸。
你在家吗？
我不在，我在我朋友的家。
我朋友的家。
我朋友， we didn't use 我的朋友 because when the positionship is with the people, we can omit the 的。
So, 我老师，我朋友，我爸爸，我妈妈。
And also because after 我朋友, we need to use another positionship,
的家。
We don't want to keep using 的，我的朋友的家, that's too long. So, 我朋友的家。Okay, on the video tomorrow, we will learn some time and number-related vocabularies, phrases, sentences. If you want to learn Chinese systematically, you can check out my online courses. You can check the course link in the description below. And if you think this video is helpful for you, don't forget to give me a thumb up. That will be really helpful for me. Okay, I will see you tomorrow. See you next video. Bye-bye.